Okay. Let's continue. Where is my... Hopefully the unicorn is still there. I really hope so. Alright, that's not the entrance we went in. Should be over here. Please be there. I'm not expecting it to be, but... It's gone. We're back to running for everybody. It was good while it lasted. You like the Grand Champion? He has a cool storyline. Yeah, it gets kind of crazy. Yeah. I have... Oop, Jimmy. Whoa, so many people hate me in this town. Actually, I want to activate his quest. Here we go, the Grey Prince. Do I have health potions? What am I like equipment-wise? I haven't actually done a check over yet. So I've got brandies, that's for healing. For fatigue. Two weak normal healing potions. I don't think I have. I have no rum. Can I make some potions? Let's see. Oh no, they took my other stuff because... God damn it, because I got arrested. I lost my two stolen alchemy. I'm gonna have to go and steal some more stuff. This means our potions won't be as strong, unfortunately. Strawberry does health, doesn't it? No, damage is health. Mix that up. No. We can't make any healing potions. If you see any deer running around.
Filthy pickpocket! What did you take? This ends here.
Run, my fellow tea friend. That's what happens if you try to steal. That's crazy. The AI in this game is actually pretty cool. I have to give it that. That was so random. Yeah, they confiscated my potion, making stuff and my potion equipment and my potion. Even anything that had a red hand on it, I took. So anything stolen I had is gone. Better get stealing again, I guess. That's what's gonna happen. Alright. Now since we're back on foot again, let's gather as many ingredients as we can. Oh jeez, you scared the hell out of me.
You'll make a fine pair of boots, huh? Take that.
And dance.
You move a ah!
You wanna get poisoned? Enemies nearby. Alright, we just gotta run. Get away from these enemies. Might have to stop in the anvil, get some potions. Help me get over here for this quest. Cheap bandit, what's new? Oh, there we go. We can wait an hour now. The reason I waited an hour, if you were wondering, it restores all my health. How's my equipment doing, actually? I haven't done a check on that in a while. Let's do... Let's repair all this stuff. Oh, I should sell that mace. I don't use it. Nice. I'm just going to carry a silver dagger in case we come into any ghosts, but that carrying that mace is just very heavy, so... Get her. Nightshade, nice. Nightshade's a really good poison. Wait, I repaired everything. At least we're getting better at that. What are my skills at the minute? Level 9. Yeah, that's why things are getting a lot harder. So, our blade is doing pretty good. I think we don't go up in our level to be level 70, I think. Sneak, we're okay. We don't sneak that often. Alchemy actually really doing really well. The one thing I don't usually use that often in Skyrim, in Oblivion, which is pretty nice. Nightshade is a good poison in real life too. Yeah, I know. Alright, so I think someone's chasing me. Why are you guys always with battle axes? Oh. Alright, let them fight each other. I'm not getting involved. Waste materials. Health. If we can catch this deer, it'd be nice. Come on. Yes. We can use venison to make health potions. That's one way to hunt, huh? Running around swinging a sword. Rude but effective. Not getting involved. Unless you're physically in my way. Go away. Kavich. Alright, so we need to get here. Get in, buy some health potions. I think we're going to be fighting skeletons and ghosts and stuff like that. We're going into a dungeon, so... Deer. Come on. Hey. Right, let's see. Can we get pseudo one? Where'd he go? I lost him. God, I can jump like a freaking frog, man. Aloe vera. That's really good for health potions too. You're back. Bethesda doesn't do any bug fixes. Brew. They kind of do. Get out of here, wolf. Look. Frickin' wolf has gold. What's the deal with that? Why? Nothing of use. Not. Yeah. Ooh. Damn it. I have my torch still lit. Hey. Good. Oh crap, get out of here. I hate these things. Vader in this game are tough. We gotta run. We're not gonna win this. Juxigal knows when to run from a fight. He's no Grognak. He's not a barbarian. He's a sneaky pirate. Yeah, he'll never compete in a fight with Grognak. Not any day. I'm amphibious? Yeah, that's true. But he's more of a lizard than a frog, I guess. Well, they do bug fixes, but they market it as a whole new game. Special edition, true. Oh. How are you doing that? It just works, guys. It just works. Don't question it. Stop questioning it. It just works, okay? I don't want to hear any questions. He knows when to hold him and he knows when to fold him. Why haven't I uploaded my Twitch stream to YouTube yet? They're going to come up on the days that they release. So my Morrowind will come out on Wednesday. My Elden Ring will come out on Saturday. On those days. So let's wait. The way I want to structure my channel, if you guys are watching this, I'm wondering, I want to structure it so I'm not just flooding everything out one day. I'm spreading everything out so my channel doesn't get saturated with everything in one day. So Morrowind. So we'll have Jock tomorrow, Juxigal Monday, Tuesday, Morrowind Wednesday, the upload from Twitch and the live stream on the night, and then on Twitch. So my YouTube, on YouTube, you'll be always a week behind. On YouTube, if you want to watch it on the day, you can catch me on Twitch. Same with Elden Ring. I'm when it comes to Morrowind, I'm uploading the entire thing. Not in small chunks like I do with this. You're getting a lot of lag. I look good on my side. Let me know if anyone else is having lag. I'm 60 frames. Why am I still holding torch?
Is there something with which I can assist you? Perhaps you're curious about joining the Mages Guild.
No, I'm looking to buy potions. You don't. You don't sell potions. You?
Yes.
No.
Goodbye.
9 viewers, yeah. Welcome everybody, whoever's new there.
Well met.
Welcome to the stream. Thanks for tuning in. I appreciate it.
Good day.
We do a lot of Elder Scrolls content if you guys are new. A lot of it goes on YouTube, so feel free to check out my channel.
What?
What? Potions, please.
I offer the finest goods and lowest prices in all Cyrodiil.
Did I miss the health once? Healing. God, you're expensive, man. Do you sell the ingredients, though? Weak healing. I'll take them. I'm gonna make a bunch of, I'll buy that. I'll buy that.
You bought that for a song.
For a song? Am. Yes, restores health. Fortifies health, damn it. Damage. Damage. Sweet cakes, yes.
You drive sweet roll. Bargain.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Now,
take care.
What am I missing out of the two things to make potions again? I know the guards took them on me, so okay, we need the two kind of vials. Good evening. Can I just slip in over here? Don't mind that. Sorry about the book. Damn it. I don't have any invisibility potions. Never mind. Look, we'll get it fine. Let's make some potions. Aloe vera. Boar meat. Rum. We name our potions rum. You guys are running. Our health potions are always named rum. Am. It's one thing I love about Oblivion. So you can just rename just about everything. I love that kind of being able to name everything. As that little extra bit of roleplay to it. Sorry, I'm just... That restores fatigue and health. That's pretty nice. Strawberries make poisons. If we're going to be fighting... If we're going to be fighting zombies and stuff like that, I'm not too care. I don't really care about poisons too much, but... We might make a few over here. I think that's all my health stuff. I have a bunch of fatigue potions, so I'm okay in that sense. Things. Good. Let's remove that. Remove that. Let's make some poisons. Damage health. That's what we want. Let's pick one I know that damages health, and that is Nightshade. Yeah, that's true. But like, you can name weapons, you can name potions and stuff like that. I love that sort of style. Damage health. What else can we add here? Damage is luck. Burden. Oh man, thanks for the raid. Really appreciate it. Welcome everybody. Thanks for tuning in. Welcome back. Thanks for tuning in. Thanks everyone. Thanks for the raid. Welcome. We're back playing at our prior playthrough. Jock Seagull. How's everyone doing? Thanks for tuning in. So we name our poisons and our potions. Made a bunch. We're going on a bit of a quest here. You hope I'm doing well? I'm doing pretty good, man. Thank you very much. How was your stream? How was Jock? He's doing pretty good. Then my unicorn ran off of me. Yeah. Unfortunately. Yeah, that did happen. Yeah. So we lost our unicorn, so we're just doing the quest for the Grey Prince in the arena. So we're getting on with that. So we're going doing a bit of a dungeon dive at the minute. How's your playthrough going? I don't move as fast as your character anyway, I can tell you that much. Hey, disappointed that the unicorn escaped. Didn't escape. It was never my prisoner. I thought we were friends. I guess. Oh crap. Alright. I should be really keeping an eye on the damage of my weapons. Use my silver dagger. Thanks for the follow, man. I appreciate it. Alright, let's repair my stuff. No travel, no fast travel for the fighter skill is a pain. True. It can be, especially when I lost my unicorn. I was getting around so much quicker. I should really save up and get a horse. Just bite that bullet. But, oh, wait. Oh. Right, where am I? Where is this place? That's across here. I didn't mean to use magic there. Aloe vera is like the best thing in this game from health potions, I tell you that much. It's the blue flowers of oblivion. Yeah, it can be a bit of a pain, but I don't mind it too much. I'm actually quite enjoying the exploring. Oblivion again, actually getting to see the areas that you don't normally get to see. But saying that is, you get pretty tired of bandit after bandit. Grognak would have eaten the unicorn. He would have hunted the thing to the end of the earth just to eat it. True. If anyone's wondering, Grognak is my Skyrim playthrough. I actually played that one over on YouTube, if you want to check it out. Hey, skeletons. That one was... The archer must be a high level one. Does he have a different name? Guardian, yeah, so that's why. The other one was just a regular old skeleton. Alright, that's... I was about to near pop another potion there, goddamn. Using dwarven weapons. Well, Grognak would eat... Well, Grognak could eat a unicorn. There is one in Skyrim. Is there a unicorn in Skyrim? It is official canon. Like, a unicorn is a real thing in the Elder Scrolls, if you guys are wondering. Okay, we can't wait, so we can't heal. I was in more skeletons around here somewhere. Alright, Skellies, where is? Crap. Wait, he's only using. This is a normal one. Alright, there's more. This is the one thing I hate about Oblivion. Is this, like, if you wanted to fast travel, or you wanted to wait, you physically can't until you defeat all the enemies, and half the time it could be some guy stuck a mile away. Alright, this guy's gonna be a higher level guy. He's got silver, and he's got a shield. Okay, we disarmed him. Good, let's keep it up. Do not pick that weapon up. Sit down there. You stay down there. There we go. You should install the killable children mod. So Grognak can eat them and skin them. I don't know how well that would do with the YouTube algorithm, alright. But if Joxeagle is a play on Jack Sparrow, he would be Hector Barbosa. I'd have to sit and think about that one for a minute. Anyone have any good ones to play on? Hector Barbosa, huh? Hector Barbosa. I don't know. You guys throw some ideas out there. Oh, yeah. I've entered Crawhaven. Crawhaven? Somewhere inside I will unlock the truth that Argonaut Gro-Malog is searching for. I should be cautious, however. The fort has long since lost its noble tappings, and presence of evil is unmistakable. Does that sound like something Gronak would say, Jack would say? I don't think he's that well spoken. Alright, let's carry onwards. Freaking wolves. How are these wolves in here? Was the gate not locked? The eyes are so dumb. It's one thing Bethesda got weird in this game. His eyeballs. He just couldn't do them very well. No, I don't have. I don't know Oblivion well enough. I'm gonna sit and think about that one now for a minute. If I come up soon, I'll let you know. God, there must be a hole in the wall somewhere here. There's rats and freaking wolves in here. Look, a coffin has more money than a freaking bandit. It doesn't have to be Oblivion based. It has to. It could be Elden Scrolls based. You know what I mean? Even though Joxeagle is not really an Elden, like an Elder Scrolls play on words. It's a play on just Jack Sparrow. And I just chose another bird. The seagull's a pretty dumb bird. Why I chose it. Holy crap. Oh, I don't. Oops. Took some bones. Alright, is that the way I want to go? What's the rest of this place? Where's my local map? Yeah, that's where I want to go. What's in here? The burial halls? Alright, we'll check that out later. Maybe a new character, Captain Victor Harkness, or something like that. Seagulls are known to be... Seagulls know what they want. And they're very vocal about it. True. But they are one of the dumbest birds out there. They have a tiny brain, apparently. They're just so big and heavy, they just kind of brute on top of everything. But yeah, that's true. Joxeagle here isn't really quiet, even though he's a bit of a thief and a sneak thief.
Your presence here will not be tolerated.
Oh, I forgot. Freaking vampire guy's in here. This is the second vampire today we're fighting. Alright, let's get some poison on this. Where are you? Get my out of miss, man. Oh, yeah. Alright, that's nice. Let's hit him with another one. Let's see if we can disarm him, too. Oh, I missed. Right. Oh, don't mind the human blood. Where is my healing? Alright, let's just pop a poison up here. Slow death would be nice, yeah. An elven dagger. I think the elven daggers are really cool looking. Okay. Oh, nice. So, Lord Lovidigus. Is that how you say his name? He was a vampire. Chest. That's a good thing you kept that chest, the quill locked up in that chest, you know. Pretty important. Red letter. I was heartbroken when you rejected me. Tell me what I can do to win your heart. I will slay trolls, walk through thorns. Okay, slaying trolls and then walking through thorns is a bit of a jump. Fast for a week. Please don't shut me out of your life. I love you more than a flower needs sunshine. That's kind of cute. Not many rival pirates in Oblivion unless you count Bulvus of the Maria Elena. True. Many dogs were murdered in the making of this game. Just the sound effects of the wolves. Your patient lover. Ooh. So patient. Yoink, yoink. Mine now. This guy's been living here for a long time. At least as old as that, how old that orc is. God damn it. I put him out of his misery. I did. Alright, here's the journal. We'll take that in a second. I just want to check around here. He still has wine at least. But I never stood though. Like, how does this stuff stay lit for so long? Now, this guy's been locked up here for what, 30, 40 years? And the reason he lived for so long is because he's a vampire, so that makes sense. Why does he have food? How is the food not rotting? Oh my god. We got 7 pages to read through here, guys. Entry 1. Beauty. Pure as sublime. That is the only way to accurately describe my love. The maiden Gromalag. True, the orcs of Tamriel are often vilified by other citizens of the Empire. And rarely would they be considered a pleasure to look upon, especially in Oblivion. I've always taught magic. Could you carry all you carry and not show it through vampire magic? I know, but still, yeah. I'm not going to question it anymore. I'll be quiet. So, is my maiden Luctruv? A rare breed of orc, unlike the rest of her kin in physical appearance. Nay, in fact, she is perfect, representative of her race. Green skin, muscular frame, and all. Good. Beauty she is, all the same. For who I am, I judge. Who am I to judge? Who am I to criticize? When so many would condemn my very existence. I can only hope my love is understanding when she learned of my unique condition, for I have yet to reveal that my most precious of secrets. Entry 2. Damn politics of my station, taxation and trade, negotiations and meetings with this disingenuous aristocrats. It is sometimes enough to make me regret my birthright altogether. I've spent the latter half of my life hiding my identity, guarding my secret, but now I am faced with an even greater challenge. For if the word were to get out that I have fallen in love with a servant and an orc, no less, I would be ruined. Such in the life of Cyrodiilic noblemen. Entry 3. Curse me for a coward, but I have not yet found the strength to tell my beloved Luctrov the truth. Perhaps it's for the best, for what benefit is there in her knowing? She would share all my fears, but none of my abilities. Her life would become one of doubt and uncertainty. Still, if she is to spend her remaining mortal days with me, she has the right to know the truth. Entry 4. Jai. Exhilaration. She is with child. My beloved Luctrov is carrying my child. You know, I'm just thinking, can vampires have children? I guess so. But I never really, I thought they would have been. They're undead. The midwives predict a boy, and we have already settled on the name Agronach. In truth, I never realized such miracles were even possible. Neither did I. But the divines have granted us their blessing, and so shall it be. I must wonder, of course, if my dear child would share the dark gift, and only time will tell. Must not, though. Like, he mustn't. Like, I don't think he carried the gift. Like, he has strength and stuff like that, but I don't think he carries the gift, and his skin's a little grey rather than green. Entry 5. Tonight will be the truth will be revealed. I will tell my beloved Luctrov everything. She'll know who and what I am, and we will decide how the best to raise our precious child that grows in her womb. 6. Betrayal. Foul and loathsome harlot. How dare Luctrov question my motives, question the love I have for my own unborn child, when she has learned the truth that I, the Lord Leviticus, am no longer human, that I have walked Tamriel as a vampire for the best of 200 years. How quickly she judged me. So I'm a monster, am I? Perhaps I should have proven her right. Perhaps I should have drained her dry when I had the chance. But my love for her, as deeply as a man has ever loved a woman, and I have wanted nothing more than to bring our baby into this world and embrace my new role as father. Perhaps my Luctrov has come to her senses, for she refuses to come out of her room. We can have a rational discourse about our future. I do not, however, retain much hope. Entry 7. Imprisoned in my own home. While I slept, Luctrov locked me in my private chambers. She called me through the door and told me her plan to escape with her unborn child. She means to keep the baby from me. When I get free, I will find the traitor's whore and rip the child from her very womb. Entry 8. 2 weeks. 2 weeks have passed since Luctrov locked me in my own quarters. I try as I might. I cannot free myself. I cannot breach the doors. If I don't free feed soon, I will go mad. Entry 9. Food. Blood. 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 I need it. Blood. Need blood. Entry 10. ... Oh my god. Alright. Crazy. Let's take it. We need to bring this back to the orc. I have discovered the journal of Lord Leviticus. It does indeed contain information of Argot Gormalach, Bert, but proves he was a spawn of a vampire. Argonach won't be happy to hear this, but it is proof he wanted, and I must take the journal to him at the Imperial City Arena, Bloodworks. I always thought they couldn't have kids unless they turned one. Yeah, right. Yeah, I've... That's a bit of a serious end. Yeah, look. And the one thing that took down the vampire was a locked door. Sad. The door defeated the vampire in the end. But he's been starving all this time. Yeah, vampires can't die. They'll just starve and go just crazy. But they won't die. They're immortal. The vampires literally don't need to eat. Hence why, like, what's her name? Who's the vampire lady? What's her name? In Skyrim? What can I think of her name right now? She, remember, she was locked in that tomb underground with this Elder Scroll. And you bring her up, she was there for thousands of years. You gotta go, Unglue? No worries, buddy. Catch you in the next one. Alright, our story time's over. Now we can get out of here. Rena, yeah, that's the one. Yeah, she was locked in that, like, tomb for thousands of years. Why'd she not go crazy? Alright, we need to make our way back to the arena. We also need to go to Coral. And where else do we need to go? We need to go to Breville. How about we do a loop? How about we go to Coral? We go to Imperial City. And then we go to Breville. How's that sound? It's good to me. Let's drop a quick save here. And that's where today's episode's going to end today, guys. I hope you're enjoying this series of Jock Seagull, or Captain Jock Seagull. I've been enjoying it so far. We're getting further and further into the series. A lot more to come, guys. We're doing this live on Twitch every Sunday at 10:30 p.m. The link is down in the description below. You want to follow me on Twitch and catch it live. You want to catch the actual live series, or if you're enjoying just watching it and a smaller section cut down on YouTube. Drop comments, drop likes, and subscribe. It really helps out the channel. Don't forget to hit the bell notification to get notified when each video is going up. And we also do plenty of live streams here too, guys. So don't forget to come join in, chat, get to know us. And join the Discord if you guys really want to join our Elder Irish community. Hope you guys are enjoying it. I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye-bye.